She makes a move at midnight. She got the magic touch. That little girl is dangerous, just a bit too much. In the midnight hour, about the stroke of 12, she'd be stepping out. You're gonna raise some hell, and it's a boom. She's holding that wild card. Gotta make her move. She'll make your life so hard. High heel sneakers, a head to toe in lace. Such a dangerous body with the little girl's face. A little Miss Dangerous, little Miss Dangerous to me. So dangerous tonight. Oh, yes, she is. Looking for trouble, looking for sense. Walking on the wild side, she's so complex. She's on
And now, it's time for Ted Nugent's Spirit Campfire with John Brenkus. It's the physics of spirituality with attitude.
Mm-hmm. dedicated to you, John Brenkus. This is the Ted Nugent Spirit Campfire with John Brenkus and Shemaine Nugent, the physics of spirituality, the physics of spiritual sexuality tonight. Happy October 5th, America and beyond, and New Zealand and Australia and Europe and all you other countries that wish you had a constitution, a bill of rights. But we're going to celebrate that piss and vinegar and the middle finger of freedom and defiance right here on the Spirit Campfire. Johnny, how are you, you little monkey? I can't hear you. What do we got? Where's his microphone? Turn him up.
Hold on. That was my fault. That was my fault. All right. So listen, I'm significantly younger than you are.
Yes. By,
you know, 20 plus years.
How old
and,
are you?
How
old are you,
I'm 49.
Oh, wow. When I was 49, I was climbing trees one-handed.
And you're eating the prunes.
And I'm eating prunes. So
already.
Kind of acting, like, kind of like not acting my age.
Well, John, I got to tell you, a happy, happy October 5th. I've got Shemaine, the Queen of the Forest. Be a happy Sadie and Coco in here somewhere. Right. I'm celebrating Patriot Mobile.
Patriot
Mobile Cup. And I want to say happy October to everybody out there.
Yep.
John, how are you doing tonight? Are you pruning? You know, I pruned some trees earlier today, but you go ahead and prune yourself.
You want to know what? I love prunes. I've always loved prunes.
I love prunes. I'm a pruner.
Listen to me. And people tease me about it, and they call me old, and they say I'm a grandpa, which I'm not yet. And I don't care. I'm that comfortable in my own skin that I will eat prunes in a big bucket, wear it around my neck like a horse, and just eat them all day. I don't care.
Well, I think if we're talking about a healthy lifestyle and a healthy diet, certainly prunes would be an upgrade from candy and sugar.
Yes.
In fact, here's a little Uncle Ted tech tip that I'm going to unleash the Queen of the Forest on you. Here's October 5th, 2020. We have a fly in the shop.
Yeah.
I'll kill that fly with a large caliber.
Kill it with a large caliber gun.
We're here to celebrate positive energy and positive spirit, which, by the way, we've really been like a damn the torpedo all systems go. All hands on deck on the Spirit Campfire. So big salute to you, John. A big salute to everybody out there.
Yeah.
A big salute to Patriot Mobile for coming on board. Mm-hmm. Everybody make the switch to Patriot Mobile. But on this wonderful day, I'd like to wax poetic a moment, if I may, Brenkus, because I get communication literally every day on my Facebook, even though it's suppressed by the First Amendment haters out there in high tech.
Right.
But we're improvising, adapting, and overcoming. And a big salute to Linda Peterson, my son Toby, and Doug Banker, my entire team who helped put this together, Courtney and Harold, and whoever makes your prunes, a big salute to the prune pickers. That takes a lot of hard, that's the physics of spirituality.
That's right.
All those prunes. How does a prune start out? Does that start out as an avocado and it just gets old?
No, it's a plum. They're dried plums. Come on. You know that.
I did know that. I thought I'd ask that. Because if you're not having fun with me, then you shouldn't be here because you might hurt yourself because I give up so much positive energy that I can't really stand myself. But I got to tell you, you know, you say your friends are teasing you about prunes. Shemaine, let the people know. Shemaine has this wonderful book that I'm going to once again let you know
that
you get this book. But it's about taking care of your sacred temple. People tease you about prunes. You might want to check what their Mr. Hand is bringing up to Mr. Mouth. Shemaine, in a synopsis on the Spirit Campfire, what is the first step? I mean, Shemaine's an old gal. She's an older
really
gal.
Old.
And she
How
really
old is Shemaine?
Care of herself. And it starts with diet and conscientious physical activity.
How old is Shemaine?
I'm 58 and I'm proud to say that. And I have been through a lot in my life. I've been through trials and tribulations. And I think that
she married me. There's your trial and your tribulation.
I mean, dude,
I know.
Like, seriously.
That's where the gray hair comes from. But I think that, you know, we need to look at aging differently, John. Like you had said, like you're proud. It's okay that you eat prunes. I'm proud that I have wrinkles. I'm proud that, you know, I'm not perfect. But every
day, she is perfect.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Well,
last time I checked,
I'll take
perfect.
That. But you know what? Every day I get up and try. And you know, John, that we lost our home. We lost our health to toxic mold. And just today I spoke with, I would say an A-list, without saying who it was, an A-list celebrity.
Yes.
Okay, an A-list celebrity who yes. called me about potential...
This is the second A-list celebrity that
called
us.
Do you mean other than me?
Other than other you, than John.
Okay.
Well, that's, that's your A-plus.
That, except that list, John, the A stands for a different word than this A-list.
Stand for something else.
You know, go and on. Here's the thing. I think that when you lose your health and you're lucky enough to get it back, you yeah. praise God every day. And for me, I feel so grateful. Every day I wake up, I say my prayers. I am grateful for the little things like my health, like being able to, every day I work out, right?
Like an animal. I have to leave the cabin because she plays the most absurd music. It's like this goofy ass YMCA or whatever it is. She plays this dance music. So I have to go out and kill stuff just to settle my soul.
But it makes me healthier and happier.
Yep. She works out like an animal every day. John, it's like the Olympic orgy marathon madhouse exercise thing.
I'm with you.
The best thing that we can do for ourselves right now, no matter what your politics, to take care of your health. And, you know, whatever that means for you, whether it's running or biking or yoga or meditation.
Wake surfing.
Or for him, he's Tai Chi. Ted does Tai Chi every day, right?
I do. I cut trees with the edge of my hand.
Yes. Tai Chi is.
I actually chopped down the mountain.
It's important to do something every single day. And that's why I wrote that book, because I believe that it starts with the little things. Sometimes, you know, we get older in life and we get into our 40s, 50s, 60s and beyond. And we go, how do I even start? I'm exhausted. I'm overwhelmed. So that's why I wrote that book, 4 Minutes to Happy, because it's the little things that you can do.
It is.
To change your life every day. Like eat prune.
The little things add up. Here's one thing, Ted, I'm a man of science. I'm a man of numbers. I'm a man of statistics, all right? And when you look at the statistics for the fatality rate for COVID,
it's almost non-existent.
It's virtually non-existent, right? Like it's like if you're, and I can pull them up for you because they're just-
99.9% survival.
Exactly. It's obscene. Yeah. It's obscene how low they are. And listen- this is no disrespect to anybody who unfortunately has succumbed to COVID. Look, it's a virus like everything else.
Or any health complication.
Yeah. Any health complications, right? Keep in mind that 7,000 people every day in this country die from something other than COVID. 7,000. So all that I want to say in terms of everyone trying to put in perspective the fatality rate of COVID and what do we do? And, you know, so, and this is a non-political statement. President Trump comes out of the hospital and he says, look, don't let COVID control your life. We all have to live our life. Let's march on. Now, here's why I would say, like, really listen to that statement. Whatever you think the fatality rate, not the get sick rate, the fatality rate, like you die from it and only it. The fatality rate is so small. It's so tiny. It represents Let's just say in the worst case, so everybody over 70, it's like 4% or something, really small. For people who are, you know, 20 and below, it's like 0.01%. It's really small. But if you take that and then you take the other 7,000 people every single day who die and they have a thing that's like beyond this screen, right? It's the fatality rate of everything else is 100% because it represents everyone who's died on that day. So the COVID people are really small. Everything else is everyone. So just what I would say is put everything in perspective, seize the day. Don't be scared out of your mind of driving in a car or riding a bike or walking downstairs or getting whooping cough or malaria or COVID. Look, the chances are if you're a betting person, you're going to live. You're going to survive. It's very few people, and again, no disrespect, very few people succumb to anything, much less COVID.
Do you think all of this is about COVID?
And obviously, listen, we're like keeping it non-political, obviously everybody knows what's going on. I think everybody knows that there's something very strange occurring.
But actually people don't. There are
I don't know. I mean,
if you want to keep it non-political, there are some people who don't, who believe in the mask, who really think that the masks work. So if that's true, if the masks are the end all be all, and I know you guys don't want to get political, then why wasn't it okay to the mainstream media that Trump drove around in his with the mask on?
If I may, Brinkus, because after all, this is the TedNugent Spirit Camp.
No, you may not, because it's between me and John here.
It's just between me and Shemaine. Ted, you just sit there and be pretty, all right?
Here's what I'd like to say. A big salute to you, John, because the leader of the free world showed great leadership today. And to simplify his statement that you have focused on, God bless you for doing so, if we can convey anything on the Spirit Campfire, we're always humping positive spirit and positive energy. The most positive thing to do now, as my buddy John Brenkus just articulated, don't be afraid, which takes us full circle back to the opening hysteria of tonight's October 5th Spirit Campfire. Take good care of yourself.
Yep.
Eat prunes instead of sugar. drink water and good, healthy, quality, natural, organic tea instead of, you know, sugary sodas and sugary pop. The simple things. I have a lot of friends out there, and I run into them everywhere, every day, no matter where I go, John, at the local sushi bar, which, by the way, there's a place called Aka, A-K-A, in Jackson, Michigan, of all places, that I swear to God, John, it has sushi that is better than any that we had in Japan.
Well, equal to Japan.
No, it's better than most. There was one in Japan where a guy spent $1,000 per mouthful.
Was crazy. I remember Anthony Bourdain recommended this place.
Yep.
And we went to this amazing sushi place. And I remember looking at this sushi chef, whatever you call him, and behind him on the counter was this something that was moving. It was still alive.
Yeah, squid. There's some squid.
Holy squid.
We're supposed to eat it.
Some breeding squid that we're going to eat raw. But my point is that I just wanted to hump this Aka, a.k.a. sushi restaurant. An entrepreneur put this wonderful restaurant together in Jackson, Michigan, and it is just
amazing.
A taste bud heaven. So, my really point is that Shemaine and I, tonight we had fish. We had fresh fish.
Cod.
Yeah. And we had some wonderful rice. Yesterday, she actually cooked up some kind of gonzo chicken.
Yeah.
Chicken
cacciatore.
We had some. Okay. We have some pheasants hanging. I shot three beautiful white-tailed deer with the prettiest arrows you could ever imagine. So we're sharing the venison with local soup kitchens and neighbors and homeless shelters and charities. But my God, everybody, what is Mr. Hand? And this goes right to the core of the real pandemic in America that's killing more people than COVID, and that is shitty choices of what you put into your sacred temple. So here's a big celebration on the Nugent Campfire. Talk to your family. Talk to yourself. What is Mr. Hand taking off the shelf and putting into the grocery cart that will end up in your home that your family and friends will eat? And I'm going to tell you, John, is it 70 or 90% garbage out there? I see what people out with their shopping carts, and I'm going, who would let someone that you love eat this shit? So here's a little October 5th celebration. Let's all make a real conscientious choice on how we're taking care of ourselves. Because if we want to save America, we're not unless we save ourselves first. So that's a little Uncle Ted tech tip on the Spirit Campfire, brought to you by Shemaine.
All right. Everybody listen to me. I don't want to harp on this subject, but I do want to make a point.
Important.
So this is from the CDC. This is straight from their website. Now, whether or not, I think the CDC numbers are way high. So take these with a grain of salt, but this is the survival rate. Like, meaning you get COVID, what are your chances of surviving? I don't know how many nines you need in a number. 99.997. I mean, that's basically 100%. I mean, there's going to be, a person here or there, and that's tragic and it's terrible. But look at these survival rates. This is straight from the CDC. There's not made up numbers. I just want to put that in perspective. And I've got another amazing site that everybody that I'm going to share with everybody from at the Spirit Campfire here. I'm going to show you a site that's amazing, Ted.
I like here. It that you're getting more political, John.
This is not,
I'm not getting political.
This is civil rights. This is about caring. Wait, this is about caring about your fellow Americans and using political. Your head. It has nothing to do with politics.
Nothing. I'm not saying one thing or another.
Many people are wrong.
You don't see this information on mainstream media. Right.
No, but I'm going to show you. Here we go. Everybody can go to World Life Expectancy. So check this out. You're going to love this. World Life Expectancy. Okay. So check this out. Cardiovascular disease worldwide. Look at this. Cardiovascular disease. 13 million people have died this calendar year. From cancer, 5 million. Respiratory, 3 million. Digestive, 1.5 million. Psychiatric, almost 1 million. Look at this. Look at these numbers. This is World Life Expectancy. This website has been around forever. And when people are like, oh my God, I can't believe how many people died. Look at AIDS. We all think like, oh, AIDS. Nobody dies from AIDS. 1.5 million people have died from AIDS this year, since January. It's
I see the next category. I see the next category. I almost died of diarrhea today.
Look at that. Diarrheal, which is basically dehydration. Look at tuberculosis. Yeah. Oh, I mean, it's just unbelievable. Look at the flu.
What is that one? Child what?
I don't know what CLUS is. I'm not sure. Yeah. Look at this. Drownings. This year, 300,000 people have drowned. I mean, it's crazy when you start putting everything in perspective and go, gosh, how dangerous is it? And look at this. This is the one that I love. Population, 7.7 billion. World births, 107. Deaths, 44 million. Listen to this. We've added 70 million people. Like, we're not going to run out of people anytime soon. Trust me.
Brenkus, a big salute.
A lot of people.
A big salute to you, Brent, because this is really, really important. And what Shemaine said, a lot of people would interpret this as political. This is not.
It's not.
This is social caring. We care about our society. We care about our fellow man. So, again, what this does is this fans the flames of truth, logic, and common sense from our great commander in chief, President Trump, when he said, don't be afraid. And the best way to not be afraid is to eat prunes instead of sugar to take good care of yourself. So it came full circle.
All right. I'm going to take off. You guys,
what are you going to take off?
I'm going to take off right now. I'm going to take off this shirt and then I have another one underneath it.
Wow. Whoa. Easy. Family show. Hey, Ted.
All right. Have a good.
See you, Shemaine.
See you, John. Good luck with those drones.
That's right. Here's the stat of the night. So far, there have been 1 million people in the world who have died from COVID. That's tragic. That's terrible, right? But does anybody have any headlines for anything? Look it. Here are the infectious diseases. More people have died from AIDS by 50%. More people have died from diarrhea. More people have died from tuberculosis. Like, nobody cares about that. But more people have died from it.
You know what, John? I think, you know, and again, I'm a gregarious guy. I hang around. I know you care. I know Shemaine cares. I know I care. So that's 100% in this environment. And everybody I know, my sons, my daughters, my grandkids, my brother, my sister, my team, my band, my crew, I'm in touch with them every day, John.
Yeah.
It's not just about, we're going on tour and these are the people you hang with. No, these are my friends. These are my cohorts. These are my fellow working hard, playing hard American shit kickers that bust our ass to be in the asset column. So what you're emphasizing, Brent, is which by the way, on October 5th at the Ted Nugent Spirit Campfire, this is another indication, conclusive in my way of thinking, that you, Brenkus, deserve me because you care. And even though the media, remember, fake news, the things they've been saying about me, because I stand for God, family, country, freedom, entrepreneurs, law and order. And if I may, on October 5th, I would like to take a hold of this and go through my spirit rehabilitation moment, which I have about about 150 a day. But go I was on. In a tree just before I came to the Spirit Campfire. Yeah, if you notice, John, when I join you at the Spirit Campfire, would you think I qualify as bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, kind of a bubbly, buoyant individual every time?
For sure.
Because I take good care of myself, and this time of year, I just climb out of a tree surrounded by honking geese, actually a pair of swans. I didn't hear the sound of the geese until I heard the whoosh, 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 whoosh.
Right.
And the swans went right by my head.
Crazy.
And I didn't flinch because I think Simon and Garfunkel wrote the song Sounds of Silence. I live that stuff. So I want everybody to take a deep breath. And John and I and Shemaine were talking about quality of life begins with respecting yourself.
Yeah.
Respecting your gift of life from God, the physics of spirituality. And I'm going to emphasize that my quality of life and my focus and capability of making responsible choices in life has a whole lot to do with my lifetime of the samurai spirit. And you see this over there? The samurai spirit.
Yep.
Mystical flight of the arrow, where I aim small. My goodness, an X on the bullseye. So a little emphasis.
Wow.
There's a lot of good advice here on the Spirit Campfire on October 5th, but I'm going to tell everybody in response to the tsunami of inquiries I get, you see how archery makes me really excited, focused, happy, kind of the physics of spirituality, fulfillment. Hey, everybody at the Spirit Campfire, get a damn bow. Go to your local archery shop. Join your state bow hunting club or archery club. Find that expert at the archery shop, the sporting goods store, that'll take the time, like Brian Shootback at Shootback Sporting Goods in Jackson, Bruce Cull at Dakota Archery and Sports in Yankton, South Dakota, Dan Olson up in Bear Lake, Michigan, George Britton over in Tarpon Springs, Florida. Find someone who will spend a little bit of time. John, 100% that have followed that advice have literally fallen in love with a bow and arrow that is graceful, easy to draw back, and brings your whole spirit into a focus of the path, not the path of your arrow, the path of your life. So, hey, everybody, get a bow and arrow. You can buy a used bow for a couple of bucks, get some arrows, go to the local archery shop, join your local archery club, bow hunting, state bow hunting organization, and I'm going to tell you, your spirit will soar on the wings of an eagle through the simple focus of the mystical flight of the arrow. I promise you. I've lost John's voice. Let me hear John's voice. Bring John up.
All right, that's my bad. Here we go. Listen, I have, this is where I was just about 20 minutes ago. So here's where I was, hanging out on the lake, wake surfing, having a blast, eating with friends. We had sushi on the boat.
Oh boy.
It was just unbelievable. And this brings me a tremendous amount of joy. And other than the cost of the sushi chef, it was free.
Yeah.
So it's free. And it's awesome. For me, that's my happy place. Just being on the water, it's amazing. And everybody, I have so many comments. What I'm very glad about is there's so many comments saying, What website was that I was showing? That website is called worldlifeexpectancy.com. Worldlifeexpectancy.com. Everybody go check it out. And then just do your own little research and be like, wow, a million people have died from COVID. A million people have died from car crashes in the world. Like, cars are dangerous, super dangerous, but you still drive them. So, you know, that's all I say about that. Now, Ted, the little things in life. I've been waking up early, and I'm telling you that there is just something about the air just when the sun breaks the horizon.
Hello.
Oh my God. It's like electric. It's like all of a sudden the birds come awake and the sound of the insects fades and the sound of the birds, you know, rises and the air starts to breathe and everything starts to warm. I'm like, I was never a really big morning person. I was always a stay up really late at night. Now I stay up late at night and I wake up early in the morning. So I'll sleep when I'm dead. And I'm telling you, getting outside when it's, even when it's that brisk cold in the morning, it's amazing. It's a little thing.
You know, you're articulating the battle cry of the hunter and the fisherman, because it is that awakening of the world around you that permeates your very soul, your skeleton, your being, your heartbeat, your breathing. And it's those mornings in the hunting season, especially October, November, December, and all the way into Texas in January and February, where that really has been a soul cleansing, healing power. And that brings me to the confluence of your identification of the awakening within and around you as the sun is coming up and the life that springs back. But you also showed that wonderful website that really got somebody's attention on the Spirit Campfire, because that information is intentionally hidden from us pretty much everywhere. And the information that coalesces that entire statistical survey is that the medical community will tell you, and I will tell you here now on the Spirit Campfire, that the estimate is between 95 and 97%, which if I was 95% gonna kill a deer, I'd probably be eating venison. That's how high a percentage that is. That 95 to 97% of illnesses and health problems that humans experience is a direct result of stupid choices, i.e. smoking, drinking drugs, stupid sugary food in obnoxious proportions, failure to exercise in a meaningful way, a mental spiritual invigoration. So if our Spirit Campfire conveys anything, it's that John Brenkus is in charge of his life. I think everybody knows, which is why, John, I think you and I connected, is because Ted Nugent has always been in charge of my life. You know, there was a time that there were female influences that were in charge of my life to a great degree, but even in that chapter, I was in charge of my life. So at the Spirit Campfire, rugged individualism begins with the individual. Quality of life always begins with you connecting your brain and experiences in life to draw the conclusions that these guys ate and drank and smoked and did drugs and they're dead or they're drooling or they're sick or they're whatever. Don't jump off that cliff. That cliff ends up with a pile of dead bodies. Don't jump off that cliff. You saw the people jump off that cliff. And I'm going to emphasize again, we started this, just a half an hour ago.
Yeah.
The sugar intake by Americans.
It's insane.
It's insanity. So get some prunes instead of the damn candy. Now, I have to admit, I like a Three Musketeer bar in my duck blind if I'm there for more than 2 or 3 hours. But that's maybe, two a month? During the duck season, which only lasts 2 months. My point being is that I'm 72 in just another month and a half. And I'm cocked, locked, and ready to rock the Glock, Doc. I'm alive. I'm healthy. I know the bags under my eyes are increasing because it's the hunting season. I'm pushing myself a little bit too much. But I eat smart. I rest smart. I'm very active. And I make sure that Mr. Hand doesn't put Mr. Garbage in Mr. Mouth. So that's a celebration I think the Spirit Campfire should always emphasize.
Yeah. And if someone wants to join our talk tonight, we have a really easy link. TalkToUncleTed.com.
Wow.
TalkToUncleTed.com. If anybody wants to join the campfire, from now on, it's going to be TalkToUncleTed.com. Make it really easy for everybody.
I'd like to emphasize a couple things here. Number one, you referenced our great president overcoming his positive test to a degree where the medical community, the greatest medical community on planet Earth, their Walter Reed Hospital and his personal presidential team. So let's keep the president and the first lady and his family and all Americans in our prayers who are suffering from this, but mostly pray for them so that they make smarter choices in their life. We don't believe the mask is the end-all cure to avoid any influenza or any flu. We have to use our heads. We think that a lot of these politicians around the country that are shutting down the world and inducing fear and making unconstitutional decrees and actually punishing people, viciously punishing people for not obeying, you know, tyrannical decrees. So the next step besides individual health is individual freedom. And I hope that people watching the Spirit Campfire tonight do what I do on all my Facebook lives and all my interviews. I do interviews every day, John. And we have to contact and communicate on a regular basis with our elected employees, our mayor, our governor, our senator, our congressman, the White House. Let them know what you believe. For example, all my elected employees know that I support law and order, that there is no quality of life without law and order. And cops can't back away from arsonists and rioters and people beating people. You don't back away from evil violence. You stop the evil violence. So that's just a simple social studies Ted Nugent campfire reminder that if you're not speaking out on the things you believe in, nobody knows what you believe in, which is right. Why there's chaos, so, because good people didn't call and say, hey, you know, Mr. Mayor, we should have law and order. Hey, Mr. Mayor, if people are throwing firebombs at stores, maybe those people should be stopped and put in a cage. Just simple common sense communication. John, it's the missing link for quality of life wherever you find quality of life compromised.
Totally. You know, and one of the big things that we like to emphasize is to look, we're being positive, stay positive. And I mean this, I am so absolutely sincere when I say this. I'm an absolute registered independent. I am an independent spirit. If you can make a persuasive argument and if you have a set of values and if you've got something that you can convince me you represent my point of view, I'm going to vote for you, whether or not you're red, blue, green, purple, doesn't matter what party. Right. So that is me. I am independent mind. Anything that I say is certainly not politically motivated to get you to vote one way or the other. It's really to get you to vote and to think, and you can draw your own conclusion. To me, the answers seem to be pretty obvious these days, but everybody can draw their own conclusion. Now, with that being said, one of the things that will allow you to make a better decision for yourself is to not put garbage in your head. People are putting garbage in their heads. They're reading garbage. They're listening to garbage. They're hanging out with garbage. They're like, just don't. When you know, I mean this sincerely, when you feel like, God, that is a crazy idea that I just can't get on board with that. I just can't. Then leave. If you don't like where you are, leave. Go to a different room. Get away from that person. Turn the channel. Get rid of your phone, like get it out of your head. And all of a sudden life becomes not so stressful.
You know, you're talking about being informed and communicating with your neighbors and the people that you work with and getting some feedback. You know, I'm going to give a big salute to what I think may be the last of the dying journalism out there. I think if you watch and listen closely to Tucker Carlson, you will get more meaningful information. I've listened and watched everything, and I got to tell you, when I corroborate and attempt to corroborate the evidence, I just think that Tucker Carlson is the cat's ass. This guy does research. Yeah. He backs up everything he does. He doesn't give you his opinions unless he's got a bunch of people who were on the front lines to corroborate his reporting. So there's a little Uncle Ted tech tip and a salute in a world of fake news and misinformation. The guy's got balls.
And you want to know what's interesting about Tucker Carlson? If 5 years ago, he annoyed me to no end. He was like a little smarty pants. And I was like, this guy is like a frat boy know-it-all. And he really has evolved. He got into this rhythm of understanding, well, when I present an argument, if I'm slightly sarcastic, but not like a total weasel, people are going to listen more. And I think he, if he were to run for president right now, I bet he'd win. Like, he makes so much sense. It's unbelievable. And he calls out Republicans all the time.
Because they deserve it. Yep.
So
I'm going to give a big salute to some friends that have sent in a bunch of these patches. God bless these heroes of the military and law enforcement. This is the SWAT guys from North Sound Metro, the Linwood Police Department. And again, it's because these guys know that those of us who demand safe streets and neighborhoods, we have to rely on the heroes of law enforcement. I thank them all. I've always supported them. This isn't something new with Ted Nugent. In fact, some guys were sending me some interviews from 1967 and 1968, and then there was some early ones on the David Letterman show. And I said the same thing, because the truth has always been the truth, and common sense has always been common if you're sensible. So I appreciate the communication I get. I got some wonderful challenge coins from these guys. I'm really humbled. I'm really genuinely appreciative of all this stuff. I try to reciprocate. It's getting hard because I'm so busy all day. I haven't got back to everybody, but a big, big salute to all these heroes of law enforcement, military, and the first. Oh, and John, I got to tell you, hang on to this one. I've got many, many dozens of these. This came in. Let me just read where this flag will be on my wall of honor, presented in honor to Ted Nugent. This flag was flown aboard an airborne multi-intelligence systems aircraft on September 7, 2020, during a combat mission in an undisclosed location as we readied to deliver unspeakable violence to evil men who must not be allowed to flourish. As this flag flew, it symbolized the unity of the United States of America and the United Kingdom in their unshakable resolve to keep our country safe. It was an honor to fly your flag on board our aircraft. Yeah. John, if
unreal,
how can I not have faith, confidence, and the belief in the warriors when they so honor me? I've got so many of these. A lot of them aren't even on display, because what they tell me is that they send me these things. I ended up contacting them personally, and they all say the same thing. None of them knew each other, hundreds and hundreds of different heroes of the military. They said that they do this because they hear my interviews. They watch our Spirit of the Wild TV show, and I'm always making comments. They're watching Spirit Campfire, and they say that I stand up and fight for the things that their brothers died for. So I know I'm a loudmouth, and I know I'm hardcore, and I don't compromise and back down, but let that be an indication. I receive these tokens of appreciation from the heroes on behalf of everybody out there who believes in God, family, country, Constitution, Bill of Rights, Declaration of Independence, law and order, the First Amendment, the Second Amendment, all the amendments, all the God-given individual freedoms that are guaranteed in those sacred documents. So when I accept this stuff, I'm not doing it on behalf of Ted Nugent, the guitar guy. I'm doing it on behalf of American families who stand shoulder to shoulder with me, and the confidence and the consistency with which I am able to experience that on the social media, even in the suppressed form. I thank you all from the bottom of my big Detroit barbecue heart and soul. God bless, God, family, country, patriots out there. I sincerely appreciate what you people are doing, but you need to be louder. You need to express your beliefs to your elected employees so that our core beliefs end up getting back into policy making. That's what a constitutional republic is supposed to be.
Absolutely. Ted, we got to give some love to Patriot Mobile, because look, they came aboard as the first sponsor for Spirit Campfire. And look, they're America's largest and only Christian conservative network. As a cell provider, everyone just needs to switch. If you don't, if you really think to yourself, are my dollars going somewhere to support a company that supports people like I want to support? and you got to switch to Patriot Mobile.
You know, and you talk about activism. That's the perfect activism. Support a company that has the balls to stand up for the most controversial stuff in the world, which happens to be God, family, country, freedom, law and order, the First Amendment and the Second Amendment. It's unheard of nowadays where a big corporation will come out and actually stand loud and proud. Patriot Mobile, I kid you not, if you really believe in this quality of life that is unique to America, make the switch to Patriot Mobile.
Yeah, Ted wants to shoot another arrow, and the room is going nuts tonight. They're saying, Brenkus, you're making so much sense. So, I don't know. You know, maybe there's a Brenkus Nugent ticket. Maybe we'll run for, you know what we should run for? President and Vice President of the Spirit Campfire.
I think like we're already there, brother. I nominate you if you nominate me.
I like that. Hey, everybody's saying, Ted, please play a song for us because we're all gathered around the fire. We have a very engaged audience tonight. And people are they're really pining for a song here.
I got a lot of response to Fred Bear done electric last week. They said I heard from a lot of guitar guys. In fact, by the way, speaking of now, I don't know what that is. That sounds cool, doesn't it? I've never played that. But anyhow, there is a rock and roll fantasy camp masterclass Ted Nugent guitar spirit orgy coming up. The one on October 7th is already sold out, but I understand there's another one. The full title is Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp Masterclass Ted Nugent Guitar Get Down on October 10th at 3 p.m. And I understand there's a couple spots left. So I guess everybody, we go for over an hour. With knowing me, it'll probably be 2 hours. But you get to ask questions, intimate guitar questions, or quite honestly, I've made this perfectly clear. I don't know what the other rock and roll masterclass fantasy camps did, but on mine, you can ask me anything you want to ask me. You can go anywhere you want to go because everything about my life ends up on the guitar because I like to think that I'm one with my instrument. So you want to hear a song? How about that?
we got a special guest coming, I think. Herbert's going to let a special guest come on.
Tonight, right now. I'm game for anything.
Tonight, right now. We got a special guest. We gave a shout out to him last week. And he's coming back. Here we go. And he's connecting. Everyone, drum roll, please. And Herbert, bring him on. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Steve-O.
No, kid, Steve-O is out with us.
Hey, Uncle Ted, how you doing, man?
How you doing, brother? I see you have a spirit campfire going. Steve, you in Chicago? Are you okay in Chicago?
I'm doing all right. I'm surviving. I'm in the bowels of Chicago right now, man.
So Steve-O is a true Gibson Birdland aficionado. He's been out hunting with us and killed a pig. He came to one of my private campfire guitar lessons. Now, how does Steve, I know, have you watched all the spirit campfires so far?
I have, every Monday and Thursday.
Now, how do the guitars sound over this technology? Are they coming across like the Birdland we know and love?
Oh, it's insane. It's awesome. I can't get enough of it, especially since I couldn't see you on tour this year. The tone is unbelievable.
My heart's broken. So, by the way, Jason and Greg and I keep in touch all the time. We're going to get together and we're going to do our best because Jason is a technology freak. So is Greg. I'm not. But I think with those guys guiding me, we should be able to, John, to put a jam session with Greg and Jason here on the Spirit Campfire. Keep our fingers crossed.
Awesome. Totally.
We will definitely be able to. We'll be able to link everybody together. We have a great musical platform that will link everybody together. They can play in real time. There won't be any delay. I'm telling you, there needs to be like a damn Yankees reunion. There's got to be a Ted Nugent reunion. I'm telling you.
So, Steve, how many Ted Nugent concerts have you been to?
I just started listening to you at the end of high school in 2010. And since then. Yeah, about 10 years, I discovered you. My first time I saw you was at the Star Plaza Theater in Miraville, which I know you've been to quite a few times. I'd say I've been to about 15 shows of yours.
Okay. I talked to a guy last month. Actually, it was in September, who has been to over 200 of my concerts. He saw the Amboy Dukes in 1966 outside of Chicago at a place called the Bat Cave. And he's
That's
been
awesome.
To over 200 concerts since. And here's the great testimony. And this is what just drives me into the stratosphere of confidence, which is ultra dangerous. He said 2019 was the most intense, the tightest, the most electrifying and ferocious tour he's ever witnessed because of Jason and Greg. And believe me, I'm not knocking any of my bands. I've had Carmine on. I've had Derek on. I had the damn Yankees. And I'm proud as hell of every gig, every concert, every tour of my life. But Steve-O, you have to, and maybe you don't have to admit, but this guy admitted, he said, I don't know, he just unsolicited testimonial said, but last year, Ted, at Pine Knob in Detroit on August 31st was the best concert I've ever seen. It was over 200 shows. What did you think of last year's tour, especially at that place outside of Chicago? What was that place called? We did two nights there.
St. Charles.
St. Charles, Illinois.
The Arcata, yes.
The Arcata, yes.
John, every year I see Ted, swear to God, I leave the show, I'm like, he's only getting better. It was better than the last time I seen him. I mean, I just walk out of there with the biggest smile on my face. It's the time of my life. I try to bring all my friends and family to see you. I swear to God, it's more intense and ferocious and nastier than the time before.
Well,
God bless you, Ted.
And you got to admit, man, what Greg and Jason do, every song, it's like it's like their last statement in life. This might be the last song we ever play. We're going to do everything we possibly can. But every night there's that passion, John. All the different artists that we've talked to. I mean, we talked to Billy Gibbons. We talked to Ricky Medlock. We talked to Derek. We talked to Jack and Michael and Tommy. We had Mark Farner on. We got coming up, by the way, in the next couple of weeks, we have Kevin Cronin from REO Speedwagon. We had Dave Amato on, another world-class musician. All these unbelievable talents. And you know, there's a consistency there. And I imagine all the other concerts you've been near, other artists, Steve, I mean, you got to admit the passion put out by artists, by rock and roll bands, it's very inspiring to see this kind of energy, even from old guys like us.
Yeah, and I try to see, you know, when they come around, ZZ Top and AC/DC, and I've seen Van Halen when they came to Chicago, and they're awesome. They're great, but there ain't nothing like a Ted Nugent concert, that's for sure. Ain't nothing that comes close.
Well, I like the idea, John. How about that Steve-O is actually at a campfire? He's doing he's on the Ted Nugent campfire from a campfire. Steve-O doesn't mess
around. Show us the campfire again, because that is, look at that. That's a real campfire going.
Hell yeah. There's no other way to do it, guys. No
hey, Steve-O, let me ask. You know, we've got this Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp Masterclass coming up. Have you signed up for one of those yet?
No, I haven't.
You don't have to, because you were right here in the man's cuckoo's nest when we did it face-to-face.
That's true. You know, I'm supposed to work that day, but I'm trying to work out something where I can come join you guys. And I tell you what, that pork jam that we did last year with, I think, about five of us, that was the time of my life. I mean, I can't even describe. It was so special and so intimate. I hope to God I could do it again next year with you, because it was.
What he's talking about, John? We do these pork slams every weekend. We got. In fact, right now I got to tell you, right now Paul and Jim and Toby, where's my phone? We've got a bunch of really special needs hunters right now at Sunrise Acres, and it's called the Christ Outreach for the Blind charity.
Wow.
Christ Outreach for the Blind. And do you know that we have blind hunters out there right now? Not, it's dark now. They've left the, of course, if you're blind, I guess it doesn't matter if it's dark, but they were hunting all day yesterday and today. We have some young men and women who are totally blind. We have a number of quadriplegics that are completely limited. We literally have to put a blind over them in their chair in a hopefully location where the hogs might come by. And of course the guys really know the travel routes, and they shoot their firearms. The blind guys shoot with an assistant who has a scope off the side and is touching their shoulders.
Wow.
And they have to do it in such a way they can't speak or they'll scare the game. They do it in such a way the blind hunter or the quads, the paralyzed hunters, they can barely move the firearm and touch it off by sipping and puffing on a special technology. And Steve, we didn't have any special needs on that hunt, but you can tell as a guy that hunted the first time, there, you know, we call it the physics of spirituality. The emotion when you're in that hunting camp campfire and then magnify it by someone who can't walk on their own, who can't see, and they're able to be guided into a kill of a great hog for pork, and then share the stories around the campfire. So again, the Christ Outreach for the Blind. And then we have the Record Rack sportsmanschoicefeeds.com. We're gonna put that up on the screen too at some point. But we're gonna announce the nominees for these charities for the military and law enforcement and first responders. So the hunting season isn't just about the hunt and killing. It is a time of family gathering. And Steve, as it was your first hunt on this pork jam where the guys get a guitar lesson, they get to go pig hunt with me. Pretty special. I don't think Jerry Garcia ever offered such a thing. Could you feel a unique and special camaraderie?
Yes.
In a hunting situation that was different than anything else?
Absolutely. You know, and that was the first time I even shot a gun. I used Toby's, what was it? His 450.
450, yeah, Bushmaster, yep.
Bushmaster, yeah. And that was the first time I ever shot a gun. And from the moment we woke up, you know, before the sunrise, like you guys were talking about earlier, it was spiritual. It was so special. I mean, and the whole day, it was, you can't compare it to anything else.
Steve, you sound like a guy that's really tuned in, and I'm glad to call you a blood brother. I'm glad that you love the guitar slamming, and you love the fact that you aim small, miss small. You discovered the mystical marksmanship of a firearms experience. So we really appreciate you choosing those pursuits with your old guitar playing Uncle Ted. We really appreciate that. I so cherish the experience of baptizing people like yourself into the world that so turns me on, that is so exciting for me. And I'm glad I got to share it with you, man.
Thank you so much, Ted. You're the best. I think of you like a father figure. I love you, man.
Well, I'll remember that awesome. Time I beat you.
Oh, there you go. All right, Steve, thank you so much.
Steve, I love you, buddy. God bless you, man.
Thank you, Ted and John. You guys are the best.
Is that unique or what, huh?
It's unique, you know? I mean, it's incredibly unique. It's special. We're making connections all around the world, and we're not doing anything other than being positive. I don't know. You know?
I think we spread a lot of really important information tonight. I thank everybody for supporting us. Again, a big, big thank you to Patriot Mobile. They really put their beliefs on the line with people who share those core beliefs that really are, history will show, and it's not a mystery at all, that quality of life begins with God, family, country, neighborliness, positive energy, the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, freedom of speech, the right to keep and bear arms. So here's a little Uncle Ted tip to wrap up the Spirit Campfire on October 5th, 2020. Be sure you're a member of the National Rifle Association. It really is a civil rights organization, because if you don't have the right to keep and bear arms and defend your life, you haven't got any civil rights at all. And there's an organization that I'm a member of, John, that I joined as soon as it was formed years ago. It's called the United States Concealed Carry Association. United States Concealed Carry Association, because you've seen where people have righteously defended their lives and they get charged with a crime for self-defense, clear and unambiguous self-defense against a threat to their lives and their family. So the United States Concealed Carry Association, I think, I don't know what it is, USCCA.com.
Right.
But I'm going to promote that on this show, because if you don't have the right to defend yourself, you haven't got any rights at all. So Brenkus, we started this off with prunes, and that came full circle. The quality of life is about quality of fuel. So it beats the hell out of sugar. I salute everybody. I hope you're having a great hunting season. We're having a wonderful hunting season. A big shout out to everybody around the world who joined our campfire tonight. We will see you Thursday. Dig this, John. Talking about a gift from God. We've had incredible guests. Huckabee and Sarah Palin, Biscopo, Mark Farner, the greatest guests in the world. If everything goes right, either Thursday or next Monday, and I'm not just saying this because I never just say anything, the greatest governor in the United States of America, South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem.
Oh, honestly, she, like, I could not, like, everything she says,
It's unbelievable.
Brilliant. Yeah. Secondly, you're like, this is an amazing American. Yeah. And I am so excited to have the opportunity to chat with her, as everybody else will be. She's incredible. So let's all pray that it all works out and nothing crazy happens between now and Thursday.
Real soon, we'll have Governor Kristi Noem from South Dakota. We're going to have Kevin Cronin from REO Speedwagon. I'm working on my number one guitar hero in the world, Jimmy McCarty of Mitch Ryder's band. He's got a killer band now in Detroit. And the original drummer for Mitch Ryder, Johnny Bonanjic. We're still working on Wayne Kramer from the MC5. We're still working on... yeah, sure. I can't remember everybody's name. But anyway, we're working on a bunch of killer guests, but let's all pray that Governor Kristi Noem will come on. Tom Morello, we're talking to Tom Morello. Tom is a different cat, and he's an incredible virtuoso and a great, great family man. So we have some amazing guests to keep the level of amazing guests on the Spirit Campfire alive and well. Yeah. So it's wrapping up. John, great information tonight. A very special campfire. Thanks to Linda. Thanks to Doug. Thanks to Shemaine and Toby. Thanks to Steve-O and everybody out there. And I will see you all on Facebook. I'll do some Facebook Lives. Oh, by the way, we don't know if we even have any more of these hats. These hats might be gone, but if there are any left, they'll be at TedNugent.com. And because it's hunting season, John, I'm not going to sign anymore, but these hats might be available. And if we're lucky, I will do this after November, and I will put that on there.
Wow. I like that. I like that. All right, listen, we're all going to see you on Thursday. Everybody stay safe. Eat prunes, drink some water.
Yes.
God bless.
Patriot Mobile, live it up. Stand up for what you believe in. When in doubt, whip it out.